If we had 500 years to steer global society into safe harbor, it might be possible to do that. But we don't. I mean, I really believe that we are being asked to participate in the birthing of a new order of being, and that there is reason for great optimism and hope, because it looks like we're just boring into solid rock, but in fact there's somebody else boring through that solid rock, and they have triangulated our approach and they are hurrying to meet us. I don't think we fell into this situation because of bad fate or bad destiny. This is part of the process. History is what happens when an animal species, an advanced animal, falls under the influence of a transformative attractor of some sort. History is only about 25,000 years in duration. The interesting part in the last 5,000 years, what has happened is that something confounding has entered the local situation, or was always dormant there but has stirred to wakefulness. And it is not God, not the God that in Milton's wonderful phrase hung the lamps like stars in heaven. It isn't that God. Maybe it's the God of biology, but whatever it is to us as we are to the termite. And what it is doing is it is casting an enormous transcendental shadow back through time over the epigenetic landscape of biological becoming. And in our species, for reasons mysterious to me, we mirror this thing, and it has swung our compass away from the forward flow of genetic theme and variation, and in a course orthogonal to biology, a course set on the transcendental, and it is pulling us toward it through the medium of transforming our languages, through the medium of the imagination, which is, after all, this mysterious mental domain in which we are whispered to by angels, demons, gods, ancestors, aliens, and out of that intercourse, culture, self-transforming, shedding its face every 100 years, building on novelty, is ascending toward a reaching out toward the unspeakable. This has been going on, I think, for billions of years. It has obviously and incontrovertibly been going on since the advent of consciousness in the human species. And now we're there. We're in the final domain of the confrontation with the secret. It is impossible to conceive of history going on for hundreds of years. The planet cannot sustain it. All of these social structures and institutions that we have surrounded ourselves with are obviously lifeboats. They are not made to last. They are made to carry us to a certain point in the life of the Earth, and we are now there, or we are within 20, 30, 40, 50 years of confronting the transcendental object at the end of time that drew us out of the animal body. History is the proof and the shockwave of the eschaton. This is a hard thing for secular audiences to wrap their minds around because they're familiar with hearing this from rattlesnake handling Christers. But that's simply because religion has always been the repository of the irrational intuition. it never said that the irrational intuition is ipso facto false. It becomes a travesty when hung with the trappings of dogma derived through the scholarly revelation of weasels. But the intuition is pristine, and the intuition of Islam, Judaism, Christianity, and cults innumerable is that there is a finiteness to the historical experience. And then the more staid the ontology, the further into the future they put it, so they can continue trading real estate for the next little while. I think that it is now possible to extrapolate the curves that describe our degradation of the planet, the spread of epidemic diseases, the ozone hole, the extraction of metals, the clearing of the rainforest, the rise of population, the spread of toxic compounds, so forth, to see, to convince yourself, even from a rational point of view, that history is a self-limiting process. Well, if you're a rationalist, then you must conclude we're just headed for extinction. I would think then the rational response to that logical process would be to get your ass in gear and try and avert the extinction. And if you're not a rationalist, then the conclusion you draw from all that is that we are within striking distance of merging with the mysterious hyperspatial source of our intelligence, and that somehow this is a planetary birthing, something as scripted as the breakup of Pangaea or the movement of glaciers south from the pole. It's just part of the process. A culture exists to transform mind out of the domain of matter. We are rising toward the rarefaction of ourselves into the transcendental plasmate body of alchemical and Buddhist preoccupation. This is what is calling us out of matter. It's what called the monkeys out of animal organization. It's what calls technology out of the restless hands of the hominids, and it is what is calling all of us toward a kind of fusion with the community, with the psychedelic totality of the species, and with the larger Gaian totality of the planet. This is what it all went for. This is the promise and the redemption of history. Without this redemption, then history becomes the abortion that materialists fear it is. This is why the legitimate path to the transcendental, the linking of the individual with the transcendental through psychedelics, now becomes the most important political work that can be done in the light of the rising awareness of the end of history.